guys, tight rope walkers and acrobats. They had an extensive reputation. They made their home in Victoria Grove. That was nearly their center of operation. For they were incurably given to rove. If the area window was found ajar in the basement, looked like a field of war. If a tile or two came loose on the roof, which presently ceased to be waterproof. If the drawers were pulled out from the bedroom chests, and you couldn't find one of your winter vests. Or after supper, one of the girls suddenly missed her Woolworth pearls. Then the family would say, it's that horrible cat. It was Mungojerrie or Rumpleteazer. Rumpleteazer had an unusual gift of the gab. They were highly efficient cat burglars as well, and remarkably smart at a smash and grab. They made their home in Victoria Grove. They had no regular occupation. They were plausible fellows who liked to engage a friendly policeman in conversation. When the family assembled for Sunday dinner, their minds made up that they wouldn't get thinner. An Argentine joint, potatoes and greens. Then the cook would appear from behind the scenes and say in a voice that was broken with sorrow, I'm afraid you must wait and have dinner tomorrow. The joint has gone from the oven like that. Then the family would say, it's that horrible cat. It was Mungojerrie or Rumpleteazer. That Mungojerrie and Rumpleteazer had a wonderful way of working together, and some of the time you would say it was luck, and some of the time you would say it was weather. They go through the house like a hurricane, and no sober person could take his oath. Was it Mungojerrie or Rumpleteazer? It was Mungojerrie and Rumpleteazer.